Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Wei Yi and David Navarra. This is a game from the Jerusalem Grand Prix, played in 2019. Wei Yi had white pieces and he started with knight to f3, d5, b3, then into Larsen attack, maybe. Bishop to f5, bishop to b2, e6, and now d3. Is this the ready opening? Definitely, maybe. Black to move, h6 was played. If black plays knight to f6, then white may play knight to h4. So we have h6, and if now knight to h4, then bishop to h7. Knight from b to d2, intending e4. At the right time, knight to f6. White to move. g3, going for the double fianchetto. This is very common move in this position. Now let's take it back. If e4, then d takes on e4. And if bishop takes on f6, queen takes on f6, d takes on e4, bishop to h7 and black is okay. And let's go back. If e3, then knight to c6 or bishop to e7 and black is okay. Back to our game. g3, c5, white to move. Bishop to g2 seems like the most natural move. Wei Yi played knight to e5, preparing e4. Knight from b to d7 and now e4. Even before playing bishop to g2. Bishop to h7. If d takes on e4, d takes on e4. Bishop takes on e4. Knight takes on e4. Knight takes knight. Then bishop to b5. And it is only now clear why Wei Yi was delaying playing bishop to g2. And if knight to f6, then queen to e2 and white is better. And let's go back. If in this position queen to a5 check, then c3 and after queen takes on b5, a4 and white is better. Back to our game. Bishop to h7. Knight takes on d7. Queen takes knight. Bishop to g2. Black to move. And black was worried that white may play e5. So queen to d8 was played. If something like bishop to e7, then white may play e5, attacking the knight and gaining the space on the board, sending the knight to g8. So we have queen to d8, like I said, making the room for the knight. But Wei Yi did not play e5, he played e takes on d5. E takes on d5, queen to e2, check. Bishop to e7. White to move, how would you continue? Wei Yi played bishop takes on f6, damaging the pawn structure. G takes on f6 and Wei Yi castled kingside. After 14 moves have been played, white is standing better. Black to move, bishop to f5 was played. If castling rook from a to e1, and after say rook to e8, queen to h5, and white is better. Back to our game. Bishop to f5, rook from a to e1. Bishop to e6, queen to h5, queen to d7. Castling kingside is not a good idea, so Navarra was thinking about castling queenside. It is white to move. What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Please pause and find the best move for white. Did you pause? What did you find? How would you prevent black from castling queenside? Wei Yi sacrificed the exchange. Rook takes on e6 because of this move. Some commentators were saying that Wei Yi was playing like Mikhail Tal. Do you agree? Or maybe they just wanted more views by mentioning Mikhail Tal. Queen takes rook. Bishop takes on d5. Queen to d7, bishop takes on f7 check, king to d8. With the sacrificed exchange, white has a piece plus two pawns and the attack. So, White has an excellent compensation for the sacrificed exchange. And that is not how Mikhail Tal played when he sacrificed his material. Do you agree? Rook to e1, king to c7, bishop to e6, queen to d8, knight to c4, a6, intending b5, and after the knight moves, then the black king would go to b6. Bishop to d5, preventing, or if you wish, discouraging b5. Rook to a7, queen to f7, pinning the bishop and threatening perhaps rook or queen takes on e7. Rook to e8, defending. Bishop to f3, b5, knight to a5, king to b6, attacking the knight. What is the best square for the knight? What would you do? White played a move and black resigned, and the move is knight to c6. Novara resigned. For the entertainment purpose, I will show you just one line. Perhaps black should save the queen. Then knight takes rook on a7. Black is advised to recapture with the king. Then bishop to g4. Queen to d8, defending the rook. But then bishop to h5, threatening queen takes rook. If the rook moves, then rook takes on e7, or queen takes on e7. And after queen takes queen, rook takes queen check. And I guess we can stop here. Congratulations to Wei Yi, who will now play Ian Nepomniachtchi in the final of the Jerusalem Grand Prix. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.